गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, न्यू चैप्टर वेस्ट जनरेशन एंड मैनेजमेंट मेथड्स ऑफ सेफ डिस्पोजल ऑफ वेस्ट. इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट नीड ऑफ वेस्ट मैनेजमेंट. नाउ हाउ टू डिस्पोज ऑफ वेस्ट. फर्स्ट, कलेक्शन ऑफ वेस्ट. इट इज़ द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी ऑफ द म्युनिसिपैलिटी टू कलेक्ट द वेस्ट every day and in organized manner. So collection must be done in organized manner, area wise, by covered trucks, vans or any other vehicle, so that there will be no littering on the roads. Second, there should be a day to day collection, which is very important to prevent spread of diseases and polluting the environment. Third, building materials, debris, demolition waste must be separately collected and disposed of accordingly, because all this have or can be used as a landfilling material. Segregation. Segregation means division of waste according to its nature. What is the nature of the waste? It may be dry or wet, or it can be biodegradable or non-biodegradable waste. So according to that it should be done, and from the source. Source means from where this waste has generated. Like biomedical waste, this comes from the hospitals, and it should not be mixed with other waste because these are harmful waste material. Second is industrial waste. This industrial waste also gives us solid waste. Sometimes these are biodegradable waste also. So waste from the household will come under municipal waste, and in this we have vegetable and fruits, leaves and garden waste, which can be used as a manure because these are the biodegradable waste and they will not create any type of toxic thing in the environment. But on the other side, if it is the industrial waste, it is a non-biodegradable, it have a chemicals, and it also includes sometimes e-waste. E-waste means electronic waste, and it should be treated separately, not along with the municipal waste. You can see here, municipal solid waste, it has been segregated according to recyclable waste, organic matter, debris and hazardous waste. So this is the division of segregation from its source. After segregation of the waste, now it is storing the waste. Storage facility must be provided keeping in mind the quality or quality of the generated waste. Means which type of quality it is and in which quantity it has been generated from that particular area or residential area or from the industrial area. Now, second is that if it is, it can be a farm waste like cow dung. It can be a everyday bottle waste. Bottles are there, boxes are there. So according to that, it has to be separated and then it has to be stored. So the collection bins must be covered so that the waste is not exposed to the atmosphere or to the stray animals like cow, buffaloes, dogs. They just move towards the dustbin. So these dustbins should be covered where the waste has been stored or has been dumped. Next, the storage bins must be designed so that it can be handled easily from one place to another place, or it can be put into the trucks. Then manual handling. Manual handling means there are number of rag pickers who collect the waste material by their hands without using any gloves. They are unaware about that they may be suffer from the infectious diseases or harmful diseases. So education has to be given to these rag pickers that instead of using bare hands, they have to use the gloves and they have to wash their hands after that, so that they will not suffer from the deadfall diseases. Transfer and transportation of waste. It should be done with the use of covered vans and trucks. So the vehicles should be designed such a way that it have a cover, and when it takes the waste from one place to another, it should not fall on the way, on the road, making it dirty. And the network of collection should be concerned that and well planned, that every day whatever the waste is in the bins should be collected, and overflowing have to be prevented. So it should be collected in the trucks and vans. Dumping or landfill. Landfill means it is an area on the outskirts of cities. Outskirts of cities means outer areas of outside the city areas. There may be a land which can be used for dumping the waste of the city, and this waste should be covered with the soil so that there will be no foul smell or bad smell created in the atmosphere. And but as it is the crowd is increasing, crowd means the population is increasing, so because of that the percentage of waste also increase. So it is very difficult to look after the waste, how to manage it. Now, factors considered at the time of site selection for dumping waste means whatever the waste has been generated in the city, now where to throw this, where to dump this. For this, the people, the municipalities, they have to look after the land area, and then they do it. First, like topography means land. So any large area away from the city, far from the city, can be used, and this land fills give out a bad odor or a foul smell. So it should be always covered with the help of a layer of soil, and for this there should be a people appointed there. And major problem comes because sometimes it is mixed with the water during the rainy season. So there's a water which comes out, is a dirty water. It is also known as leachate. Land requirement and its cost. The land selected for the landfill must depend on the quantity and quality of the solid waste. Now, which type of land is required? Where we have the solid waste, which can be a lowland area, so the solid waste like the debris of the houses can be put there, and that lowland area can come to the level land. Next, accessibility. The site of disposal, where whatever the land has been selected by the municipality, should be accessible so that it can be dumped easily in those areas without any difficulty. Cover is also required, and it should be at least 15 centimeter thick so that it will not pollute the environment. Climate. During the rainy season, the temperature and the water combine together, and it also create a foul smell, and sometimes the water mix, rainy water mixes with the waste, and dirty water leaks out from that area, which is also known as leachate. Now, leachate is a form found when the rain water leaks into the landfill. So water has percolated through the solid and leached out some of the constituents. The water can move easily, and you have seen that there is a black color dirty water coming out from that. So that is a leachate. So leachate is any liquid that in the course of passing through the matter extracts soluble or suspended solids or any other components of the material through which it has passed. Means whatever thing is there, whichever the dirty thing is there, if the water passes through it, maybe it is on the roadside or near to your house, So when the water flows through it, it gives a dirty water, or you can say it is an acidic water which have a foul smell. So that is called the leachate. I just give you example of the landfill from the Allahabad only. You know the Chowfatka area coming towards the Bamroli, there is the Judge's Colony. So this area was a lowland area and it was filled with the waste which has been burned and covered with a layer of soil for I think 1 or 2 years, and after that when it become little solid, then the construction of this multi-story building which is known as the Judge's Colony, which is near to APS school, maybe you are knowing this. So if the lowlands are used for dumping the waste, it can be, it will become a level land and can be used for different purposes. Composting. Composting is organic matter that has been decomposed in a process called composting. This process recycles various organic minerals or materials otherwise regarded as waste product and produce a soil conditioner. Compost is rich in nutrients. Why? Because it is a biodegradable organic waste like trees, leaves, vegetable peels, discarded foods, paper, which can be turned into manure. You can see here in the picture that there is a newspaper, grass, fruit, vegetable. It has been put into the soil. It reacts with the water and air and carbon dioxide, and the finished product is manure, which can be used in our kitchen gardens or gardens, and if it is done on a large quantity, it can be used as a manure in farms also, that is for the agriculture product. Process of composting. Process of composting includes two things, anaerobic and aerobic methods. Anaerobic means without oxygen in the air. So all the waste material is dumped inside the earth and covered with a layer of a soil so that there will be no bad odor. And it like we have a biogas in this tanks has been made in which cow dungs has been put there and covered so that there will be no foul smell, and when the gas is produced it can be used for cooking purpose or lighting of the bulb, which and this about 55% methane is there and 45% is carbon dioxide. Aerobic composting is with the help of air or oxygen, and it also causes a bad odor. This is a relatively expensive type of method, and it includes three types of microorganism. After organic material is accumulated, these microorganisms grow, assimilate the sugar, starch and organic acids, and as a result of the activity, the temperature at the center of the compost heap often rises up to 60 degrees Celsius. So at this temperature, heating loving bacteria live in the waste. After using up sugar, starch and other materials, the temperature begins to fall. At this lower temperature, other microorganisms like fungi will dominate. So in this way, they break down the biological activities, and it ends up, sometimes we also use the vermicomposting. Vermicomposting, it is with the help of earthworm. We have the compost pit in which we put all the biodegradable waste material and earthworms. Their droppings also, earthworms eat up these waste material and their droppings enrich the compost. And this compost can be used for agriculture or for the kitchen garden. Advantages of composting. Now why we have to do the composting? Because first, conversion of organic waste into valuable fertilizer. We can use the vermicomposting or the other simple process of composting. Because of this, reduction in the quantity of waste to be disposed by the householder. Like if we have the household waste, kitchen waste is there, peelings of the vegetables are there, if it has been dug in the earth and used as a vermicomposting at home only or household near the kitchen garden, so what will happen? It will reduce the waste. Recycling of organic material and nutrients back into the soil. It is the natural waste disposal system. Means all the biodegradable substance can be disposed of easily. Compost improves the texture of the soil. How the texture of soil? Because decaying of the waste gives manure or fertility to the soil. It aids plant growth. Why plant growth? Because if the soil is rich or fertile, the plants will grow well. It increases the water holding capacity of the soil. Means it do the percolation of water deep in the soil, and soil can hold the water for a longer duration. I think this chapter, the method of controlling the waste in different steps, is clear. If you have any question, you are free to ask. Thank you.